make a play just like a quarterback. Oh. We ain't worrying about no farmers, we ain't staying there. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, six range, just like Tom Brady. Touchdown,
from one of the loudest venues in the NFL, there's a look at Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Baltimore Ravens and the Kansas City Chiefs. Both of these teams about to reach the halfway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
Well, conventional football, football 101, tells us if you don't get it back to the 20-yard line on a kickoff return, that's a disappointment. But some of these teams, special teams coaches, with approval by the head coach, they give them full aggressive, almost...
They'll come out throwing here on first down. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. 16 yards on the game's first play and a quick first down. Take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
It's a gain of five.
Looking to throw. Oh, the slant complete to Green. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. 15 yards on the play, first down.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time... they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold him.
They go play action here on first down. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Chandler Jones, one of the best athletes to ever come out of Rochester, New York, in for the sack. Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. And nearly an interception here on their opening drive.
Intended for eight,
but instead, third down.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas. And he will not get all the way home, but he will take this back down to about the 2-yard line. Remember, Charles, this is the number one defense in the NFL, and they proved their mettle here, forcing the turnover on the opening possession.
And sometimes when you play a team that has that reputation, it's earned it by their play. The psychology is, okay, they're number one. They have to prove it to us, and they tried to attack. They found out that that ranking was real.
And if history is any indication, when this defense gets off to a good start, look out.
Yeah, their offense plays off of them awfully well, too.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. Mixon trying to punch it in. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Joe Mixon, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead.
Well, they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times, that's a passing play.
And the kicker just has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although, I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Lux with the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken about 7 yards deep, and this will not be returned. It'll come out to the 25.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
How about that one? The so-called little guys putting the pressure on. That was a strong safety. When I was in college, we often called that a lightning blitz.
Second and 14 as they've got work to do here after the sack. Goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got in as he threw it.
They've given him some different looks here defensively in the early going. He's only hit 2 of his first 5 passes. With a big third down coming up, he's hoping he's got a play dialed up that can take advantage of whatever the defense throws at him.
He's going to air it out deep for Green. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Able to convert on 3rd and 14. A terrific play call. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's 1st and 10 from the 45. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. That's going to go as a loss of a full 8 yards. And it sets him back for 2nd down. So now they operate back from their side of the field here. 2nd and long. They'll look to throw. But he's got the hook up here to DeSean Jackson. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for 3rd down. And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on 3rd down.
Slam route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
3 yards won't be enough here as that'll bring up 4th down.
3 yards. It's now 4th down.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They're going on 4th and 5. Back to throw. This is caught by Jackson. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. DeSean Jackson, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Ravens are an extra point away from tying the football game. So now the Ravens electing to actually go for 2 here. They'll try and throw for it. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Good positioning, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
7, Ravens 6.
So we're back to a 1-point game now as the kickoff comes. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
Over 1st and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The Chiefs' offense about set to begin this drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you
Oh, wide open, complete.
Go time, baby.
And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Calvin Ridley, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs strike quickly here for 6 points. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. And sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. That's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go long, man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. fielded near the back of the end zone. And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Now a play fake here on first down. On the crossing route, complete. That's Green. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And some space here. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 35 yards the gain there. Another first down as well.
It's a gain of 30.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 26-yard line. After one, 14-6 our score on EA Sports.
Ravens 6.
Right back to him on first down. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. He'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13. He'll drop to throw. Blitz coming and down he goes. Jordan Brooks. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been on constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. There goes a deep ball. End zone. The Kansas City defense tough to throw on there, and now it's fourth down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
Think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is.
NFL kickers nowadays, they make things look so easy because normally from this range, about 2 out of 3. And this is not an easy kick.
Yeah, 20 years ago, you get where he was in that 50 range, maybe a little over. And it's a big kick, but now we just, if they leave it short, you're like, whoa, what happened? And that's what we have here.
Yeah, you're right. 20 years ago, we were saying run some more plays and get closer. Now we think they're definitely within range, and you're exactly right. When it comes up short, there has to be something that went wrong because they have plenty of play.
And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. That's good for 21 yards and a first down. Now Joe Mixon into the secondary again. And he gets it all the way down to the 3. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Here's a run with Mixon. Able to get a couple here but won't get across the plane as they stop it right around the 1. Second and goal from the 1. They'll try to run this one in. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Joe Mixon with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. So simple math here in the first half. They've had 3 drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
The PAT up and good, but hold on a second. There is a flag. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football.
Ooh, he's running.
And he will score. Touchdown, Kansas City. Philip Dorsett, his first touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs add on to their lead. Scouts will look to add the extra point. PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. Fielded just outside the goal line. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15.
At their own 16-yard line.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And remember, this is the number one defense in the National Football League. There's a good example of why.
Shows that they set an aggressive tone, not just stopping the run, not just getting after the quarterback, but the ball's in the air. They treat it like they're the receivers, and they went after that one and took it all the way.
And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call, so that one will be accepted. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Taken in at the three. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Running back gets this to the 24 for a gain of four.
The ball carrier.
So at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Going to give this time to the tailback. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Chung. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. So his struggles just continuing here in the first half, throwing the football, Charles. Now 3 interceptions.
And they don't feel like they're just great plays by the defense. There's a sense that maybe he's a little careless with the football now. So some of the great coaches in the past, you know, they've always said, I can't teach you, obviously, because you're not listening. So maybe the bench can teach you. He's got to be careful now. He might get pulled.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
7 yard line.
They'll run with Mixon. And he's going to be down close to a first down at the Ravens' 18-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
1st and 10 at the 18-yard line.
1st and 10, and they've got 3 tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming. coming up at halftime. We remind you once again that we're going to check in with Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL as we reach now, hard to believe, the halfway point of the season. Time flying.
It certainly is. Time to get the sweaters out, my man.
And he's got the first down here and then some, but a penalty flag down. This could very well be coming back. After the penalty, it's Mixon. He's to the 10. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Joe Mixon on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Chiefs have got it on cruise control.
Will Lutz lining up.
This is becoming quite the half he's had here.
Remember in our pregame meetings, they talked about wanting to run the football and staying with it. Well, when you're scoring this many touchdowns, there's no reason to go away from it, is there? They are off to a fantastic start. They hope it continues.
Three already for him. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
25-yard line.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And that's caught inside the 35. And all the way down to the 29. A big play that time for the Ravens. 46 yards. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
When the defense wins and gets up no yardage on a running play, that's something they can build on and carry themselves forward throughout the game.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now back to throw. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one. Closed quickly, and he'll force the incompletion.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And they're going to get him down shy of the first at about the 13-yard line. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play.
Brings up fourth down.
So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. And this has no chance. It's no good. Well, wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is. So you wonder what's going on in that head right about now. That's two missed field goals for him now, and this one should have been no problem.
For an NFL kicker, you're thinking 97, 98% from this distance, and this one somehow fails to go through. And that's 3 points you just absolutely have to count on getting.
Now another timeout called for by the offense as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime.
First and 10 at the 41.
The big play to start him out has him at the 45 already. From the gun, Murray going up top for Kupp. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go. Cooper Kupp was his intended target, but it'll be second down.
Second and 10.
Throwing again, Murray. Complete, the tight end, Kelsey. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
He's coming back.
Throwing again, Murray. And that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
Incomplete on the throwaway. Leads to second and 10.
So on second down, the field goal unit is on here as they try to get three before half. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt. And this one is right down Broadway. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. An incredibly short kick fielded way up there. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. Here's Reed returning. The lane opens here. He's past the 30.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 36-yard line.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. From the 38, Murray. He'll get this one to Cup, complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. This is caught inside the 15. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Calvin Ridley with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And this offense continues to pour it on. Lutz to try to end the PAT. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter.
Makes the score Chiefs 52, Ravens 6.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded in the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
He's going to air it out deep for Green. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. He's going to let this go deep for Jackson. And that one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football here. Nearly a fourth pick. And it's third down.
Third down. And 10 yards to go.
Throw here. He's got his man here. It's Green. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 27 yards there on a very nice third down conversion. And they give this time to the tailback. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 more there and another first down.
I don't know what this says about me, but I love successful runs up the middle when the blocking is so well executed like that.
And it doesn't matter whether it's zone blocking, whether it's a power scheme, when you have a blocker on a defender and then a running back can read it, find the proper hole, and just go, sometimes a thing of beauty.
Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the...
And this is caught inside the five. And he takes it all the way down to the three.
First and goal.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. They'll try to run this one in, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season, and the Ravens are able to make things a bit more respectable. Oh, I was just about to say he had missed an extra point all season, but there it is. His first miss, no good. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Chiefs take over first and 10. At their own 26-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Again, it's Mixon. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 12 yards there and a first down.
Kansas City Chiefs.
Mixon. Strong run, but he's corralled just beyond the 40. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
2-yard line. A gain of a yard. Brings up.
They'll run here with Mixon. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
Now, that's a mountain of a man that just made that stop, isn't it? But he's more than that. This guy's nimble and quick. More than a space eater, he just made a great play there.
Throwing is Murray on third down. And it's complete to Kelsey. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. Flush to his right. Now he'll pull it down. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down. From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. And it's knocked away and incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. And that'll bring up second down.
Brings up second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down. Out of the gun, here's Murray. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
Kansas City Chiefs.
Stepping up, and he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Kyler Murray, a 4-yard touchdown scamper. And the Chiefs just continue to pour it on.
Will Lutz lining up.
Not the first time on this drive we saw him take matters into his own hands, and this time he finishes things off with a touchdown run.
You're not going to be happy with me, but I think he took matters into his own feet, didn't he?
Oh, Davis from the top rope. I like it. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taken in the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Second and 9 now. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49.
I got to tell you, I'm trying to think of something positive to say for this offense, but I'd have to be a spin doctor for that one. This has been a tough performance to watch.
And I think it's hard at this point to actually identify what's really gone wrong. I guess the catch-all is everything. Doesn't sound like real sharp analysis, but I don't have much else for you.
And the scoreboard just lopsided, and it's been ugly from the get-go.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
At their 48-yard line.
On play action, it's Murray. Going up top for Kupp. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead, because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks.
And off to the races, down the right side. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2-yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
First and goal at the 2.
They come out 5 wide, 3 of them to the right side. Shotgun now for Murray. Flush, and he's going to be swallowed up and taken down. Sacked back at the 5-yard line.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on first and goal from the 2, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But, Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, first and goal from the 2, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
On the screen, this is Coleman. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Tevin Coleman. His fourth touchdown on the year as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. The PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
Taking it about the 1. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
Three tight ends in the ball game here on first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And now here is another interception.
picked up by Deion Jones, the linebacker. So they take over not only in enemy territory, but in the red zone at the 16-yard line.
The Chiefs take over first and 10 at the 16-yard line.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
And 11 at the Ravens' 16-yard line.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
I got you, son. I got you, son.
Hey, tempo.
Again, it's Mixon. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 5 yards. Now it's third and five.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down.
Murray staying put for now. They'll go for it on fourth down.
Murray sets to throw on fourth and give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues. And for them, this train, it just keeps rolling, doesn't it? Well on their way to yet another victory.
Yeah, it's almost a runaway, isn't it? And you just wonder how anyone can stop this. They got full momentum going, full confidence going, but it's not just their own confidence that is leading them. It's the lack of confidence against their opponents now, because they see them coming and think, we've got no shot to beat this team.
And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Makes the score Chiefs 73, Ravens 12.
The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away.
Taken in at the 3. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He's got a man complete. It's a big play there for Baltimore. 41 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4.
The ball carrier.
Line of scrimmage, the 24. This is second and 6.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. Second and 6. He's going to let it fly. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late, but he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man. And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the second extra point he's missed so far. So still lots of work left to do, but here comes the onside kick. And the Chiefs are going to make the recovery. Now they're
down big here in the fourth. They had to try the onside kick. Can't fault them for the effort, at least.
No, you can't at all. And if nothing else, now you've put something that you're trying to practice, right, that you've worked on into a game situation, and now you can go back and dissect it. So if you need it again sometime, maybe you'll find a better way to do it. But, yeah, this game's pretty much done for them.
Murray's going to look to throw this thing. Caught, Kelce, left side. And he's going to get this inside the 30. First down for the Chiefs. Solid chunk of yardage, 17 on the play. From the gun, Murray. And he will find Ridley. That's complete. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Operating from the gun, Murray.
Now,
and he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, business as usual for them. Well on their way to another victory. Riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback.
25-yard line.
Try and start this drive in the air. He's going to let it fly. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
Incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25.
I think that was good strategy there, trying to go right back to him after the last completion. But this time, the defense was all over him. And they get.
And my goodness, another interception. Marcus May with a pick.
Yet another mistake after the interception there. And, gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big.
And this will be caught. And the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
That was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone. So give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Makes the score Chiefs 87, Ravens 18.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be fielded inside the 5. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory.
And now here is another interception. It's the former Seahawk, Earl Thomas.
The rookie was trying to push it downfield, but the safety bit him.
And he'll learn that you have to hold the safety. And you do that with your head movement, your eyes, sometimes your shoulders. Hold the safety so that you can get back to the throw that you really want to make. He got so excited thinking his guy was open that he made it easy for the defensive back to go get the football.
After the turnover, here's Murray. Now that'll be caught by Kopp. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, partner, when a team's up this big, this late in the game, I always wonder what's their motivation, because if it's me, I'm thinking about pulling on the reins a little bit. But for them, I don't think it's in their DNA. It's not their head coach's makeup at all. I think his opinion is, you stop us, we're not supposed to pull back ourselves.
The PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. Oh, and you just can't do that. 15 yards on the roughing the kicker call.
Absolutely inexcusable. The kicker's in a defenseless position, and he just gets taken out.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. Fielded just outside the goal line. And a nice job there on special teams to limit him to inside the 15 as he's dropped at the 14.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
And to give this time to the tailback. And brought down, but not before they're able to get it up to the 25. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
11 on the play, and the Raven first down.
And we got Mike, number 53.
A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory, and the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week, we'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Chiefs, their winning ways continue as they get it up to 7-0.